supiera que aún dentro de mi alma conservo aquel cariño que tuve para ti. Quién sabe si supieras que nunca te he olvidado volviendo a tu pasado.
Fell in love with Argentine tango in the 80s, early 80s, discovered Piazzolla as well, saw that tango wasn't just for dancing but for listening to as well. And so I decided to write something based on London because I saw that Finland has Finnish tango and Turkey has Turkish tango and many, many people in London go and dance tango after work, at weekends. I've been to a few milongas and they're very well attended, and it's kind of like a well-kept secret.
Forward, side, back, side, together. Forward, side, back.
Well, my name is Mina, and together with Giraldo, we run Corrientes Social Club. There's a place to develop people from different backgrounds, different cultures, ages, who come to meet other people and build like a community, and they dance. Some of them could be dancing for many, many years, and some of them could be just starting to dance. Yeah, so it's a nice mixture.
Someone said we tango because we have secrets, because it brings a mystery to us ordinary people.
There's actually an old saying that you don't find tango, tango finds you.
Seeing that so many people go tango dancing here in London, I think it's great that perhaps we can give something back to tango as well, something
so
unique.
This is essentially London.
Yeah, it's kind of tango, Argentine tango in sound, but with a kind of London twist, little subtle things.
Billed as a choreographer, but I think oftentimes people think of the choreographer as someone who sets all the steps and teaches everyone the steps they have to do, which is sometimes true, but in this case it's been much more a collaborative coordination of developing a language, a movement language that responds to the music that Romano's composed, that responds to the artists that we found to interpret the roles and their very unique backgrounds, and staying very true to the roots of tango. The majority of what you'll see is it's still improvised.
What helps? Sometimes it's linear, sometimes it kind of comes forward.
Yeah, come in, and then like,
you're both pushed along.
And then I would maybe kind of go around them, waiting for a moment where I can interject what's happening.
lot of people find quite hard to believe, but the dancers develop a very intricate way of communicating what the next intentions are, which gets even more difficult when there's three. So a large part of our rehearsals has been trying to develop what Daniel's called a kind of group telepathy of being able to read each other and develop movement styles and movement language that are true to the music, true to Argentine tango, but still finding a twist that's unique to London.
Hi, I'm Lesta, and I'm a jazz swing dancer, actually, so I have the least amount of experience in tango than everybody in this room. But I have learnt in the last 2 weeks, so yay. And I'll be performing it. I was contacted by Moving Arts Management because they were looking for a visually impaired dancer. I'm actually visually impaired. It just, like, intrigued me, the whole thing, like, the music, the dancing, but specifically they wanted to include someone like me, and I sort of jumped at the chance, basically.
Really good. And then keep that same tune in your head. We're going to bring in the milonga.
I actually didn't find it that difficult, and the lovely professional dancers, they taught me so well. I was really shocked because it's really hard to teach a visually impaired person generally. So I was really pleased, and I was really glad to be part of it.
So we could say the main character would be Sarah.
Yeah, I'm Laura playing Sarah. We called her like this. So this woman who is from the UK, maybe from London, who has had a passion for dancing, almost married to Daniel.
So I'm Daniel and I play Mark, which is a scientist. So it would be, you know, London-based.
I've been together some time and they've had some ups and downs. And during one of these downs, she traveled to Argentina where she met Carlos in the story, Pablo.
dance tango. Hold me through a London tango, whispering secretly to you.
Pablo,
maestro,
¿cómo dice que le va?
What are your overall thoughts and feelings about the performance?
When you started playing at the beginning, I thought I was going to sob. Mm. I don't know why, because I don't know tango, and that sound is so... I mean, if you're used to tango, you're probably like, oh, it's lovely, or... you'd obviously, you love it, it's why you do tango. But I really thought I was going to sob, and I was so sad you were gone.
You know, beautiful, moving piece. I thought that the whole storyline, as it came about, you could really see the emotion of the performers. And it was just a beautiful piece, I think, that that was quite moving.
It was a really wonderful experience to be involved in terms of inclusion. I think the biggest success kind of marker for that is when you have no idea that there is. Exactly. And it's not like it's a hidden disability or something, but when the person is so present and fully showing their ability that there's no idea, and then you find out afterwards that... there is.
Absolutely true.
So I thought that was beautifully done, really well worked by Amir.
How did you find the balance between the different elements, such as the music and the dance, elements of the narrative, the music? How did you find that?
Yeah, I thought it was really good at the beginning, having the live music on stage, mm-hmm. having the accordion player there, as a part of the whole piece just kind of made you think about the relationship between the performers and the music. And so I just felt it flowed so well. And it made me think that, you know, I wonder whether the music came first or the story came first, because the two, you know, wove in different ways and made you come up with stories and within your own head about what kind of things might have happened. There was a lot of London in the music, and so I feel like that whole London Tango thing with the chimes of Big Ben and, you know, the movements of the dancers and the way they went with that, I really loved the interplay between those two elements.
We have to have a backstory in between seeing the dancers, a little bit about their life and what they're doing and what they do as a couple and so on. But yeah, that's what she was saying.
The three main characters, Lesta and Jay, they all have backstories, so they sort of know what they do for a living and where they've been and what they've done in the last 5 years.
Won't you take me in?